We've got four blocks in Seattle that you just saw pictures of that is more like a block party atmosphere.
How long do you think Seattle and those few blocks looks like this?
I don't know. We could have the summer of love.
Oh. Summer of love. Running into a reality check after a violent weekend in Seattle that left five people dead. So you just saw Seattle's mayor from last year. She was praising lawlessness in the Chaz Chop Zone. But fast forward to today. Now she's demanding her city hire more cops after slashing the police budget and with shootings spiking 40%.
Seattle saw one of the worst late night, early morning of violence in recent memory. Mothers lost their children, families lost their fathers, people lost their friends. As a city, we cannot continue on this current trajectory of losing police officers like we have this year into the next years. When city leaders talk about cutting a department by 50%, you will lose employees. Families need security. We cannot just cut. We need a plan.
Seattle's Mayor Jenny Durkan is not alone. Other cities are regretting defunding the police as crime rises. And Democratic New York City mayoral candidate Eric Adams is calling out Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez and other progressives who have led the way on cutting police budgets.
I'm no longer running against candidates. I'm running against a movement. All across the country, the DSA socialists are mobilizing to stop Eric Adams. They realize that if I'm successful, we're going to start the process of regaining controls of our city.
Greg, remember Chop Chaz?
Yeah, good old days, huh?
But now it's the summer of violence.
Yes, it was a carnival of joy. Yeah, she's an idiot. I mean, I'm putting it out there. I'm not even going to have a condition on that. She deserves the wrath of Khan, and I don't even know what that means. I listen to Eric Adams, and I know that Geraldo has strong feelings about him. I want to love this guy. I want to believe that Eric Adams is real, right? Because he's saying all the right things. He's saying, if this doesn't stop, the whole country's going down.
Why do you doubt him?
I'm going to get to that. Because we were sold Joe the moderate. Mm-hmm. We were told that, like, you know what? Joe's basically like Trump, but without the tweets, right? And he's going to unify the country. And what happens? You know, he's just the squad in an old man's suit, right? They all jumped on their shoulders and they have a little head up there. And I mean, he's doing the opposite of unifying. He's splitting this country into groups that are either this or that. So that's why I guess I'm worried that once Eric Adams becomes mayor of New York, he's going to have the same pressures from the same elitist activist class that Biden has. And will he roll over or won't he? That's something that I worry about. But if he doesn't, we could see something great and it could spread to other cities.
Yeah, what do you think, Geraldo?
I think that Eric Adams has great ambitions beyond the mayoralty in the greatest city on earth. I believe he wants to be president, but more importantly, I take him at his word. I believe he's sincere. He's a captain of the police force. I knew him when he was the head of the 100 black men in law enforcement. I trust him. The city has gone to hell in a handbasket. He's going to rescue it. The most important thing any government can do, whatever the level of government, is keep citizens safe. Once people start freaking out about danger to them and especially their children, they act. And I think what you're seeing right now is a real rejection. And I believe this is why the Democrats did so poorly in the midterms. And that's why they're panicked in the congressional races in November 2020. And I believe that this will be the pivotal issue in the midterms. And everyone's going to get on board. And that's okay with me. I don't care if they're sincere. I don't care if they really mean it. I don't care what Jenny Durkan said. I was in the summer of love. I know what it was like. and that was no summer of love in Seattle. Ugh.
Jesse, actions and consequences. I mean, these cities are seeing it all across the country. And
criminals will get away with whatever we let them get away with. Kind of like my daughters. No offense, ladies, but it's true. When they saw Chaz out there, they thought, okay, that was a signal. We can do whatever we want. And so then they defund the police in Seattle, $46 million, a wave of retirements, shooting spike, and you know who the victims mostly were? Black Americans. So you have a white liberal mayor teaming up with a white city council under the banner of anti-racism ends up triggering a crime wave that disproportionately affects African Americans. Malcolm X said something about this.
Jesse's quoting Malcolm X.
You never thought I'd quote Malcolm X, but he actually warned against the white liberal because he says the white liberal will often pretend to be the friend of black Americans, but they only do that to use the black Americans against conservatives. So they just use them as pawns. It ends up hurting black Americans. And the city council president in Seattle, she's actually running for mayor. This is what she proposed to reduce the gun violence. You ready?
Yep.
Programs from hospital-based intervention strategies to trauma healing programs. Do you guys know what that means? I have no idea what that means, and nobody else does. So Seattle voted for these clowns. At a certain point, you have to say, these are the leaders the Seattle people chose, and now Seattle's a shooting gallery. All it does is rain and coffee out there. Now all they do is shoot people.
Yeah, what's the point?
What is the point of Seattle now, right? If you can't get a cup of coffee safely?
It's no Frasier
and listen
anymore.
To grunge and watch Frasier. Yeah. But in all seriousness, you actually have to hold accountable the voters. If you go into the ballot box every time and check Democrat, you get crime. And it's not even like there's an option for a Republican. Just next time, people in Seattle, vote for the less crazy Democrat.
That's a strategy, Katie.
I think the choice in Seattle is Democrat or socialist. So those are the choices. But, you know, you go back to last summer and you hear Jenny Durkin talk about the summer of love. And shortly after she said that, a 19-year-old Lorenzo Anderson was killed in Chaz. And when the police were called, they were actually stopped at the border of where that autonomous zone happened, and they were unable to help him get medical aid, and he died, and his family sued the city. And Carmen Best, who was the first black female police chief in Seattle, who wasn't just picked because she was a political person. She worked in the department for 30 years and had a track record of working on the street. She had all of this experience, knowing how it is on the beat. So she was a great police chief, had all of this experience and understood what was needed. They started cutting the police budget. They started ousting her because she wanted some kind of law and order. And she did a really interesting exit interview saying, look, I feel like they set me up to fail. And they absolutely did. So this idea now that Democrats are trying to clean up this mess that they made that was totally predictable because of some left-wing ideology that they say is based in racial justice, which actually has nothing to do with racial justice. It's actually getting minorities killed is one thing. The other thing now is the police just being unavailable because there are fewer of them, which means there are more victims on every level of crimes, whether it's calling 911 because someone is getting mugged or there's a home invasion. And there's so many citizens who are then left with no ability to protect themselves with the government that they pay for. So that's why you're seeing so many people buy firearms in the cities where they are allowed to do so.
You wonder how much, if somebody could calculate how much it has cost, not just to defund the police, but then when you lose these officers that had so many years of experience.
Right.
And now you lose all of that institutional knowledge, and they want to hire new police officers, but how long does it take for somebody to actually be ready?
And you have to lower the standards. Right? You have to lower the standards for new police officers, so you may not get the actual quality that you had before, and you're probably not going to be able to pay them as much because of the defunding. Mike, what question is, where is Antifa and BLM now? Isn't it
very
weird?
Very quiet.
They're not in the news
but
anymore.
That's why I'm proud of Jesse for bringing up the racial angle, because who is being victimized?
Yeah.
Who are the perpetrators? Who are the victims? It is overwhelmingly a problem in the minority community, Latinos as well as blacks, but overwhelmingly African-American. And it is a ghetto civil war, and we avert our eyes. We don't want to
look at it. We don't. We've been talking about it for a year and a half.
Not we.
I would like to quote Malcolm in the middle.
We.
How about Louis Farrakhan?
Wait, Geraldo is proud of me, guys. Geraldo is proud of me.
Oh, wow.
How's that look?
They look better on Geraldo.
All right,
your nose is too skinny.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.